I've seen a few articles about creating your own invoice database, where a person that works from home can create and keep track of his or her own invoices using Base. The database in the articles is usually called Invoice or Mini Invoice. I didn't think the articles provided enough information for the reader to fully understand what was going on, so in the next few videos, I'm going to create my own version of a home invoice database using LibreOffice Base. I've created a new database, and I'm calling this one ODB 73 Invoice Part 1 Tables. Using LibreOffice Draw, I've created a picture of what I want my invoice to look like. This will be the invoice that I send out to my customers. I'm going to have my company name and address, as well as a logo in the upper right-hand corner. It's going to say invoice here, then have the customer information, the invoice number, and date. And then down at the bottom, it's going to have the tasks that I am charging my client for. And then a little total at the bottom of the total of the tasks. I'm going to use this invoice to help me design my databases. First thing I notice is I will want an invoice database, and I'm going to have the invoice number as well as the invoice date and a link to our customer table. I'm going to have all my customers on a separate table, and I'm also going to put my tasks on a separate table. So I'm going to have three tables for this database. I'm going into Tables, and I'm going to use the wizard to create a new table. I want my first table to be a customers table, and they do have a customers table in the sample tables. I'm going to want a customer ID, company name, address, city, state or province, postal code, country or region, phone number, email address, and some notes. Clicking next. I want to create another field here, so I'm going to click the plus sign. I want this field to be website. And we'll leave this as a text varchar, but I'm going to move it up before the notes and click next. On this screen, I'm going to use an existing field as the primary key. I want this to be the customer ID and auto value. Then next. Customers is a good name for this table. So I will click finished. This table is looking good as it is. I'll close it. And let's create another table using the wizard again. Now we want to keep track of the work we've done. Looking over our sample tables, we have something called tasks. We're going to use that for this table. Here we want a task ID, the description, and some notes. Clicking next, I'm going to add another field. This one I'm going to call amount owed. I want this to be a decimal. There's decimal. And I want to give this two decimal places. I'm going to move this up. After the description, I want the amount owed and then the notes. And I'm going to add one more field. This one will be an invoice ID. And we want this one to be an integer. Now we'll notice up at task ID, we can set the auto value here, but I'm not going to because I know I'm going to do that on the next screen. So this one should be no. If you change this to yes, you might have issues. So going to the next screen where we set our primary key, I'm going to click this radio box, use an existing value, and I want this to be the task ID, and I'm going to set auto value here. And we'll leave this one called tasks. We see we've got auto value in the task ID. Then our last table, we're also going to use a wizard for this. This one is going to be our invoice table. And we've got one called invoices. The first thing we'll want is an invoice ID. We're also going to want a customer ID, an invoice date. Do we have something here for the status? Yes, we want a status, and then some notes. And I'll click next. I'm going to change this status. Instead of a varchar, I want this to be a yes or no Boolean. It's either paid or it's not paid. Let's go to the next screen. Setting the primary key again. I want this to be the invoice ID, auto value, and we'll leave it as invoices. The last thing we're going to do in this video is set up our relationships. So I'm going into Tools, Relationships. I'm going to add all three tables. I want to add a relationship between the customer table and the invoices for the customer ID. I want to check my update options. I'm going to right click on the line, clicking edit. I want to update cascade, and I'll leave the delete as no action. I also want to create a relationship for the invoice ID. Invoice ID, right clicking on the line, edit, and we will set this one to update cascade as well. Let's place this box in the middle, this one to the right, so it looks a little nicer, a little easier to read. I'm going to save this and then save our database.